The topic of today's video is how to use switches in KNIME Analytics Platform. Imagine coming to a point in your analysis where you want to be able to choose between different paths. For example, if a value X is higher than a threshold, you might want to send an email. Otherwise, you might want to update the data in your database. Put it in a nutshell, you want to switch between two paths. In a KNIME workflow, this means you have two or more parallel branches, and depending on a certain value or action, only one of the two parallel branches is activated. This is handled inside a so-called switch block, which contains a switch start node and the different parallel branches. To start a switch block, you can choose between different switch nodes, for example, the if switch, the k-switch data start, the Java switch, or the empty table switch node for tables. Similar nodes are also available for flow variables, for example, the k-switch variable start node. Depending on the configuration of the nodes, some of the output ports are inactive. The inactive output ports and all the downstream nodes are marked as inactive by a red cross. Similar to a loop, we can also AND the switch block, but we don't have to. To AND the switch block, we can use the AND IF node if we started with a IF switch node, or the K-switch data AND node if we started with a K-switch data start node, or the k-switch variable end node for flow variable switches. Let's focus on the if-switch node first. The usage of the other nodes are really similar. Here you can see an example workflow that reads and applies a trained model to detect fraudulent transactions and the data of a new transaction. The output is a prediction which is either fraudulent or non-fraudulent. I want to expand this workflow so that it sends an alarm email if the prediction is fraudulent. Otherwise, I simply want to write the classified transaction to a database. Therefore, at this point of the workflow, I use the if switch node. In the configuration window, I can select which of the branches should be active, top, bottom, or both. As I want to build and test both options, I first set both branches as active and build the workflow. Instead of setting both branches to active, I could activate the checkbox Activate all output ports during configuration steps. This keeps both branches active while the traffic light of the node is yellow and allows the configuration of connected downstream nodes. It's recommended to switch this flag off for production workflows, as this avoids unnecessary configuration calls of the inactive branches. Let's continue building the workflow. First, the upper branch, which writes the transaction into a database. Next, the second branch, which sends an email. Now I want to implement the logic that if a transaction is labeled as fraudulent, the lower branch is activated, otherwise the upper branch is activated. To control which branch is activated, I use a flow variable. It is important that the value of the flow variable is equal to either of the keywords, both bottom or top, depending on which output port you want to be activated as a result. To implement the matching of non-fraud and fraud to the keywords bottom and top, I use the table row to variable node followed by a rule engine node for flow variables to define the rules. In the configuration window, I specify the rules and define the name of the output variable. In my case, I call it port choice. Next, I have to configure the if switch node so that the port choice is controlled by the flow variable and not by the defined settings in the configuration dialog. Therefore, I open the configuration dialog and go to the flow variable tab. Here, I select the flow variable created by the rule engine node for the field port choice. If I execute the node, the upper branch is activated as the transaction was not fraudulent. Another option is to use the k-switch data start node. This node has not only two but three output ports. This means I can decide between three parallel branches. In comparison to the if switch node, the output ports here are controlled via the numbers 0, 1 and 2. As in the previous example, the logic has to be implemented via a rule engine node. Note though that here the rules have to produce the numbers 0, 1 and 2. In this example, I don't need an AND switch node as I don't want to continue my workflow. But let's take a look at another example. In this workflow, I calculate different aggregations based on a selection. Afterwards, I want to create the same composite view no matter which aggregations were calculated. Therefore, I close the switch block with an AND IF node. To summarize, we can say that switch blocks can be used to activate and execute one of two or three parallel branches, A good friend of the different switch nodes is the rule engine node, which allows us to define the matching logic to activate the output port of choice.